Coppin State wears their road yellow jerseys. Blue numbers right on their stomach reads Coppin State above and below the number. Blue trim, kind of a checkerboard pattern down the side. UMES, white jerseys, maroon numbers and letters. Reads UMES right across the chest. Myers will tip it off along with Sterling Smith. The toss up in the air. Coppin State wins it. Tariq Cephas runs the point for the Eagles. UMES 12-10 on the season. 5-2 in MEAC play, looking to maintain their third place standing in conference. Top of the key three, Kessie got it to go. Kessie is a 41% three-point shooter. Third best in the conference, and there he nails a triple to start the game.
Yeah, that's where we're going to miss Martin, because Martin's the fourth best three-point shooter in the league.
Eshad Pitt running the point for UMES, bouncing to Andino near it. Hawks move from left to right. Andino calls for a ball screen with Myers. Myers slips down low on the right block, face up, inside pass to Johnson, knocked loose and stolen. Coppin State basketball. Yeah, 40 Myers seconds gone by in the game.
On the wrong side of the ball that time. He needed to be in the lane instead of out making a pass.
Top of the key, slashing kick. Smith gets it out. A jump pass, Kessie looking right back to Smith. Now they whip it around the horn. Fripp looking down low. He zips it top of the key, left wing three. It's Cephas, back rim no. Pitt grabs the board for the Hawks. Very good rebounder for a guard, Eshad Pitt.
Yes, great body for a rebound, too.
Devin Walker between the circles. Lob down low, Myers, left block, baseline. Kicks it out of bounds. They'll call a foul down low on Jeremiah Batts. First foul. First on the team and first on Batts. Quick lob into the left elbow. Johnson face up, a foul from 15. High arcing front rim, no good. Sterling Smith raking the other way for Coppin State. Getting down the left side of the lane. Shot off the glass and good with the right hand. It's 5-0 Coppin State right out of the gate.
And Coppin looking to push the basketball.
Minute 30 gone by in the game. 5-0 Hawks trailing early. Devin Walker 40 feet from the hoop. Coppin. Zips it far side. Andino bounce down low. Johnson left block, face up on the baseline. Myers trying to post as well, can't find him. Andino, now he'll post up Myers. Left block, spins in the middle. Right-handed shot on Batts. Can't muscle it through, but a foul call. That's the second on Batts.
Already, not even 2 minutes into the game and two fouls on, I don't know how many big people are watching warm-up. Not a lot. I don't know how many, they definitely don't have anybody that can match Myers, but I don't know how many bodies they can have that can throw against them.
Myers will shoot two free throws here. Nothing new for Mike Myers. 193 free throw attempts on the season. He makes that one. Hawks are on the board. They trail 5-1. Only Jerome Hill of Gardner-Webb has attempted more free throws in the entire country than Mike Myers. He averages almost 9 free throw attempts per contest.
That's unreal.
Second free throw from Myers, back rim, no offensive board. Pitt on the right block, spins baseline shot, high off the glass, spins out. Myers an offensive board, one dribble, headed right back to the hoop, and he'll travel before the scoop shot falls. They did sub out Jeremiah Batts, by the way. Brandon St. Louis already into the game, a sub for Coppin State.
And that's for only 2 6'8 players.
Inside, Cephas, slashing kick, Smith, right wing three, got it to go, and it's 8-1 Coppin State early. Couple of threes for Smith and Kessie. Very good shooters for the Eagles. Johnson laying it off to Walker, kicks it all the way into the backcourt and heads all the way out of bounds underneath the UMES hoop. Iman Johnson will be subbed out for Dominic Elliott. Not a good start for them, yes.
Not the start that we wanted to see, anyhow, here.
Hawks down 8-1. Spotting Coppin State an early lead. Pass snatched out of the hands by Eshad Pitt, but he stepped out of bounds as he came down with it. Coppin State will inbound once again. 17:39 to play in the first. Inbounding. Smith, right elbow jumper off the glass and good. Smith with 5 early points. Actually make it 7 early points for Smith, and it's 10-1.
Man. Nice bounce, bank shot off the glass. You don't see that very often in this day and time.
And Dino running a pick and roll, long two-pointer off the mark, high rebound. Here's Cephas racing the other way for Coppin. Smith will trigger, left wing three, back rim, no. Finally a miss from Smith. Myers grabs the board, but then loses it near half court. It's back to Coppin State, baseline drive, and a travel. Kessie that time moving too quick for his feet.
But I think Coppin wants to play this pace up and down. Very quickly, it looked like. I mean, every time it's been a push.
Out there. Some full court pressure here from Coppin State. Elliott lobs it into Pitt, who quickly shoots it up. Walker, right wing, triggers from three, spins home. Nice shot to break the press. 10-4. UMES still down by six, but that might jumpstart the offense.
We hope so. Walker can certainly shoot us into the game.
Fripp passes to Abdiki, gets it right back. Right wing three. He's too strong. Myers puts from behind. Offensive rebound though for St. Louis. Down the right side of the lane. Slashing kick. Three-pointer. Smith in the corner. He nails it. And Sterling Smith already has 10 points. It's 13-4.
I think somebody's going to have to get on Sterling Smith.
16:30 to go. First half. Devin Walker with the ball left wing. Bounce pass to the block. Myers. Working on St. Louis, into the middle. Here comes the double team, trying to shovel it off, but it's stolen. Breakaway for Coppin State, 2-on-1. The layoff, Fripp crashing into Pitt. No contact, or no foul called. A right wing three, Cephas, and he knocks it down in the scramble. It's 16-4, Coppin State by 12. They have just blitzed the Hawks out of the gates.
And they're 4-for-7 from the three-point line. You're gonna blitz somebody when you're shooting that well from downtown.
Ishak Pitt, right wing, trying to work Myers down low. They do find him. He gets into the middle. Fadeaway jumper, air ball, offensive board. Elliott puts it back to the hoop. He's fouled going to the rim. And it'll be free throws for Dominique Elliott when we get back. The Hawks need to push the ball inside, but right now it's the three-point shooting of Coppin State that have them up by a dozen. It is Coppin State 16, UMES 4. A surprising start here at the Hytche. 15:49 remaining. You're listening to the Hawks. Three-point line. Dominic Elliott going to the foul line for UMES. Elliott going to the foul line. That foul that took us to break was on Arnold Fripp. The only silver lining in the first 4 minutes was three fouls on Coppin State, two of them on their starting big man Jeremiah Batts. Fripp now has one. Dominic Elliott will shoot two free throws here. Couple subs for UMES. Elon Johnson back into the game. Mark Blackman in for his defensive presence on ball handlers. And he's right now matching up with Sterling Smith, it looks like. Elliott hits the first free throw. He'll get another. The flick up, high release, nothing but net, 16-6. Hawks down by 10. Racing back the other way is Cephas for Coppin State to the trailer. Finds Fripp, top of the key, right back to Cephas. Jabs left, goes right. Finds Fripp, floater in the lane, back rim, no. Tapped long, ball loose, up in the air. Fripp has a hand to it and now controls. Kicks out Cephas, left wing three, wow. 19-6, Coppin State unconscious right now. Walker's open, right wing three. The response, got it to go, okay. 19-9, Hawks need some stops though.
You gotta play some defense, but you can't stop lights out shooting a lot of times.
Cephas trying to break down Blackman on the dribble. Couple of handoffs to Kessie, now left wing Smith hands it off. Here's Fripp, near corner. Passes Cephas, top of the key, spins around Blackman, gives it up, Smith in the lane. Hand check foul call on UMES. That's on Ishak Pitt, his first. First foul on UMES. Travis Trim will come into the game now.
Coppin very quick out front also. Two guard, actually they're playing with a three guard front, and it's kind of a tough matchup. That's why Trim's now in the basketball game again, so UMES is matching their guards.
Under 15 minutes to play here in the first half. A kick to the left wing, three-pointer open, back rim, no. Kessie misses, long rebound to Trim on a breakaway the other way. Up in the air, the layup, but the left is good. 19-11, an eight-point game now. Kessie running the point for Coppin State. Cephas goes off ball. Fripp, top of the key, trying to find Cephas. The roll reset near half court. Cephas guarded by Blackman, one-on-one. Trying to cross over, finds no space. Now backpedals again. Blackman all over him. Now going right into the lane. Wraparound pass, extra to Fripp. Left wing, he'll trigger from three. That's off the mark. Elliott got a hand to it. Blackman grabs for the Hawks. Blackman pushing up ahead. He's got Walker open in the corner. He'll trigger from three. Yes, sir! Here's a timeout for Coppin State. The Hawks still trail by five, but it's 19-14. A big response offensively with Devin Walker. He's already hit 3 3-pointers. He's got 9 points.
Looks like it could be who shoots the best 3-point.
Provide some offense if those shots go cold, or maybe Coppin State can't respond if they were to go cold.
Or if they miss, and then he can offensive rebound that. But the Hawks are now 3-for-4 for 3-point line, and Coppin is 5-for-10.
UMES will head out for some full court pressure defense. Coppin State basketball with the length of the court to go, 14-11 to play. Now the Hawks lay off a little, but still in the backcourt. Blackman will guard Cephas 90 feet from the bucket. This is what Blackman is out there to do, to pester ball handlers. Cephas shovels it off, gives it up to Dallas Gary. Senior from Buffalo, New York, and a foul called on Iman Johnson 30 feet from the bucket as Gary was pivoting away. Johnson's called for his first foul. 13:58 remaining in the first half. Smith to inbound. Slaps the basketball, looking for Cephas. Now he'll lob into the backcourt. Kessie guarded by Trim. Both number 10s on one another. 13:50 to play, first half. Kessie far wing in front of the UMES bench. Pump fake. Jabs right, goes left. Step back, can't find any space. Left wing three. Here's the pass. The shot, Gary misses. The Hawks tap it out of bounds, can't control the board. Finally starting to miss some threes, but UMES needs to gather the rebound.
Yeah, they're missing threes because Sterling is not shooting the basketball, so the Hawks are clamping down on one One guy forcing other people to shoot.
Long two-pointer, baseline J, no good from Kessie. Again, the Hawks tap it, finally control it. Here's Amon Johnson trying to run the break. He'll slow it down. Trim to run the point. Trim, front court left, 13-20 to play. Reverses court on the bounce, near wing. Looking down low, Elliott trying to post up. They bounce it down low to Dom. Going baseline on, that's Ejoku down low. He misses the reverse layup. Iman Johnson, the putback. He's fouled as he misses the layup.
Yeah, that's where the Hawks are going to outmatch him down inside, I think, eventually, as the game goes on.
Kessie picks up his first foul.
The Hawks are already out-rebounding 9-5, so...
No surprises there. The Hawks,
that's correct.
Very good rebounding team. Common State, the worst rebounding team in the conference. They get out-rebounded by over 10 rebounds a game. Now, that might have a little to do with the strength of schedule they played early in the season, but still, you would think that would eventually even out a little.
Eventually.
First free throw good from Johnson. Second one splashes through. It's 2-for-2. Hawks now trailing by just 3, 19-16. Cephas racing back the other way, and a right-handed scoop. It's good. Just the Red Sea parting for him right down the lane.
Somebody got lazy on defense that time for the Hawks. Coast to coast, 94 feet for the layup.
21-16, UMES down by 5. Trim backing up. Will reset the offense with 20 to shoot. Passes to Blackman. Blackman going right from the top of the key. Down the side of the lane, sheds his defender.
He's going to get offense.
Offensive foul called on Mark Blackman.
Yeah.
12:38 remaining here in the first half. That's the first foul on Blackman. Now, hard to see from our angle about whether if he used that forearm to gain some space. Well, that's what I imagine he was whistled for.
Yeah. Veteran officiating crew here, so I'm sure they're going to get it right.
Today's officials, Melvin Upton, Charles Robinson, and Cleveland Rogers. Cephas running the point against Blackman with a behind-the-back shimmy into the front court. Shaking far side. Passes to Shamari Triggs just into the game. Now right back to Cephas. Whips it near side. Gary looking down low. Can't post up for Joku. Instead he whips it far side. Smith. Zips it right back to Cephas. Back to the basket. 40 feet to go. Step back two-pointer. Cephas with 6 on the shot clock. Misses. Knocked out of bounds. And it's off of Fujoku, and it will be UMES basketball with 12:07 remaining in the first half.
Off his leg, I think, he brought it down, banged it off his leg, out of bounds.
Hawks down by 5. 6 turnovers already for UMES. That has been their bugaboo early.
Mike Myers back in the basketball game.
Ishak Pitt in with Travis Trim. 2 point guards out there for UMES. Trim wide open, left wing 3. Yes, sir! Travis Trim, just 1 of 2 on three-pointers coming into this game. Nails an open 3, 21-19.
He was wide open on the left
Hawks down by 2. Kessie into the game. Circus up and under layup, no good. Offensive board, though, in the corner. Now slashing towards the bucket. The shot from Gary hangs on the rim and falls through. Wow. Very difficult shot, 23-19. Yeah. Coppin State by 4.
Circus shot with the left hand from Gary.
Trim will reset the offense for UMES. 11:20 remaining in the first half. Trim far side. We got a whistle underneath the hoop, away from the ball, and it goes against Coppin State. Trying to work through a screen with Shomari Triggs, and he picks up his first foul. 11:17 remaining in the first half. The Hawks still have not dug out of the early deficit. They trail by 4, 23-19. You're listening to the Hawks Radio Network. have cut the advantage down to 4 points. They have never led in this game. Is UMES basketball, however, underneath the hoop. Travis Trim to trigger. Five on the floor for the Hawks, along with Trim and Dino, Pitt, Walker, and Myers down low. Playing with the basketball, might have a new ball. Make sure it's inflated properly.
Wipe a little sweat off of it. Whatever.
Unlike some footballs, I guess.
Yeah.
Here's a lob to the middle of the floor. In the lane, Myers hack going up. Foul goes against Brandon St. Louis. Here are two free throws for Mike Myers.
Nothing unusual, is it?
It really isn't.
I mean, they've got 3 6-9 guys, so I guess they're going to use up 12 fouls.
Myers, free throw, first one, front rim, falls off right side. He's 2 for 3 from the foul line today. He was 10 of 18 from the foul line against Florida A&M. In what was a really choppy game with the fouls. Myers, second free throw, too short again, ball loose. Travis Trim snatches it away, inside shovel to Pitt. The layup with the right, oh, he misses, and it's knocked out of bounds off of Myers. Hawks had a point-blank chance on the second opportunity. They still trail by four, however, 23-19. 11-11 to go in the first. Cephas, who is among the league leaders in minutes played, still out there running the show for Coppin State. Sterling Smith in the near wing, holds above his head, zips it inside off the hands of Gary by the sideline. He saves it. Oh, and Smith grabs a couple extra passes. Open three from the right corner. Yeah. Cephas nails it. Oh, wow. What a scramble. And it's 26-19.
Yeah, they wind up with a wide open shot from the baseline, and Cephas has made those all day.
A couple of inches from being a turnover. Instead, it's 3 points. Trim, far wing for UMES, lob down low to Myers, right-handed, oh, he can't finish with the off the glass. Here comes Coppin State the other way. Smith, he'll pull up from 15 on the breakaway, misses the J, and Dino grabs the board. Hawks dodge a bullet. Walker coming back, right corner, zips it inside. Pitt spins down low, hangs in the air, shot off the left rim, no good, and a rebound comes down to Gary. Coppin State coming right back. Skip pass, open three. A pump fake instead. Inside, high layup, no good. Rebound to Sterling Smith. One-handed putback is good. It's 28-19.
Yeah. There's three shots the Hawks should have made, though. They're down inside, point-blank range. You got it. We're going to have to make these against this team playing well. Coppin is playing well.
9:47 to go in the first half. Travis Trim far wing. Looking down low. Instead, Andino pops out, top of the key, feeds the block. Myers spins baseline, right-handed hook, no good. Tip by Trim, misses. The rebound, Brandon St. Louis gets it out of some trouble. Here's Triggs lobbing up ahead to Cephas. Skip pass, far wing three. Gary, the left-handed release, and it's a 12-point lead, 31-19. Another timeout taken by Bobby Counts.
And that's a game of runs.
.21 remaining in the first half. Hawks need to find some defensive stops. That's where this is going wrong right now, is they're not getting back in transition defense. Coppin State, give them credit, they're pressing the issue. You get up the floor fast enough and you have more openings than you might if you let the team set back in their half court deep. Shot clock not running here, so we got a whistle.
Throw the ball again.
Game clock will be adjusted to 9 minutes, 19 seconds. Shot clock, 33 seconds.
All right, so the clock wasn't running. UMES left to inbound again, now from the near sideline. Couple of subs for the Hawks. Elliott and Spurlock into the game, along with Isaac Smith. They're joined by Walker and Andino. So Hawks going deep to the bench. Couple of reserves getting playing time as UMES not getting the intensity they need, particularly on the defensive end.
Defense.
Smith zips it to Spurlock between the circles. Spurlock back to the basket, now going right. Wraparound pass to Elliott on the right block. One dribble, hook, got it to go. Just muscling up there for a two. 31-21, Hawks still down by 10.
Good pass by Spurlock that time to get to Elliott on the low block.
Left wing, Triggs holds above his head, lobs down low. Gary working on Andino, kicks out Triggs. Left wing three, open. Wow. 8 3-pointers for Coppin State in the first half. It's 34-21. Lob up ahead to Spurlock underneath the hoop. Wraparound layup, no. A wild reverse attempt there. Coppin State races back the other way. In the corner, Cephas. He stepped on the end line. Turnover unforced, right back to UMES. Hawks down by 13, 34-21. 8 3-pointers, Dave Bird, by Coppin State.
8 for 15. They'll take that any game. The Hawks are 4 for 4.
Dominic Elliott, time to keep going right. Gets by his defender, and he's hacked going on his way up. That'll go against Fajoku. First foul on Fajoku, and there'll be free throws for Elliott. 17 fouls on Coppin State. That's about the only silver lining for UMES, as they are getting a little trouble on the Eagles, but not enough to make this three-point barrage any sweeter. Free throw from Elliott, back rim, no good. Rebound Spurlock, but it was a shooting foul, so it's not 1-1, even though they do have 17 fouls. They would be in the single bonus, but Elliott was going to the hoop.
Now Walker back in the game.
Another free throw for Elliott here. Three slow dribbles. The toss up and good. 34-22. Hawks down by 12. Cephas hurrying into the front court for Coppin State. Dribble handoff. Kessie shovels it far side. Triggs right in front of the UMES bench. Jabs right. Instead, he passes it on to Kessie. Now it's Gary near side. Curling around top of the screen. At the arc. Inside shovel pass, Triggs looking for Fajoku, and it's knocked out of bounds off the UMES.
Out of bounds. Sounds like all Randall's foot or not.
It'll be Coppin State pass. to 22, UMES trails by a dozen with 7:52 remaining here in the first half. Coppin State basketball underneath their hoop. From the floor for the Hawks, Blackman, Andino, Smith, Randall, and Elliott. Hawks searching here for a defensive stop. This has been one of the most porous showings by their defense all season. 34 points, 8 3-pointers for Coppin State early. A kick to the corner, Andino trying to trap, Triggs gets rid of it. Gary with 10 to shoot. Circles back to Cephas. Going right, step back. Kicks out Kessie, three-pointer. Too short, up in the air. Randall controls. He saves it into Blackman underneath the hoop.
Yeah. Good block out by Randall that time.
Blackman going coast to coast. Some contact. Shot off the glass. Will you count it? It does count. And a foul. They give Blackman the bucket. 34-24.
That's an NBA bucket.
Oh, and now they're going to overrule it.
Yeah, he was fouled. They called a foul way out by
Wow. So now it's 1-1 instead of a bucket and potentially an and one. It'll be just single bonus as it's the eighth team foul on Coppin. Two fouls though on Christian Kessie. So the Hawks down by 12 still. Blackman, three hard dribbles, a pause, two more. Good free throw shooter, first one up, front end, back rim, no good. Blackman grabs his own board, goes right back to the hoop, makes the layup. All right, he does get a layup. And now Mark Blackman is called for a technical foul.
He was knocking off to number 11, Trish, the senior veteran from Coppin, laying on the floor. Blackman was talking to him.
34-24, and now the points that Blackman just scored might be given right back to Coppin State as Dallas Gary, nope, it'll be Tariq Cephas to the line. Why is Cephas shooting the free throws? 67% free throw shooter on the season. I don't think he's the best free throw shooter out there for Coppin State. And he misses the first. You don't have to go with Cephas just because Blackman was talking to him on a technical foul. It's not a flagrant. You get to choose who.
I don't understand. Not either.
Cephas' second free throw is good, so he splits the pair. I guess there's really no great free throw shooters out there for Coppin State to choose from.
Maybe that's the problem.
35-24. Coppin State up by 11. Blackman stays out there, but he now has two personal fouls because of the technical. 7:23 remaining in the first half. 35-24. Cephas working on Blackman in the backcourt. Backpedaling. Behind the back dribble. Cephas gets rid of it. Passes far side. Triggs. Now reverses near side. Smith. Slashing kick. Gary. Scrambling defense. He walked inside. Oh, no. They're going to call a bump foul.
Throwing hands on the hip.
Isaac Smith picks up his first foul. Inbounding from underneath the hoop will be Coppin State.
All right, okay. Defense.
Cephas inbounding. Randall doing jumping jacks in front of him. Kicks to the corner. Triggs double team immediately. And Dino and Randall all over him. A bump foul called on Randall.
Knocked him out of bounds. Wasting a lot of fouls.
16 fouls now on the Hawks. Both teams will be in the bonus from here on out. Quickly inbounds to Cephas in the backcourt. Now attacking the bucket, getting in the lane. Bounce pass to Triggs, left corner. Baseline drive, jump stop in the lane. Layup is good. 37-24, Hawks down by 13.
Yeah. A 5'9" Triggs right through the trees for a layup.
6:50 to play in the first. Smith circles round right wing. Baseline drive, getting past Smith. Blocked. The up and under layup is blocked. Here comes Coppin State the other way. Triggs going baseline again. Jump pass stolen. Smith comes right back for UMES. Isaac Smith shovels inside to Elliott. Right-handed finger roll is good. 37-26. Hawks down by 11. Defense has to pick up for the Hawks. Points will come. The stops, they need to improve. Top of the key, Gary. Left-handed release on the three, no good. Defensive rebound, Dominic Elliott swords for it.
Elliott playing well.
6 minutes to go, Elliott, pump fake. Now he'll trigger the long two. Single-digit game now, 37-28, 9 points the lead. 30-second timeout taken by Kyle. Marino, Randall, and Dominic Elliott for UMES. Elliott with 7 points. Devin Walker still leads the Hawks with 9, though he's been on the bench for a while. Tariq Cephas, bounce pass far side. Javari Josiah traveled as he pivoted around on Randall. Turnover right back to UMES. Well, that's a defensive stop, even if it's really an unforced turnover.
That's all right. That's a stop, though. They didn't get a shot.
UMES basketball down by 9. Bounce pass high post. Elliott back to the basket, looking for a back cut. Keeps it himself on the right block. Fouled. Fajoku picks up his second. And this will be 2 free throws for Dominic Elliott.
Yeah, down the yard a little bit. It's too quick for Fajoku. He's going to go right by him either side. He's done that, so that's not a good matchup for Coppin. Here comes a sub, probably.
At times this season, Dominic Elliott has been very quiet, but he has picked up the pace in the last 4 games. Free throw from Elliott. Good. 37-29. Remember, he struggled from the foul line against South Carolina State woefully, but he's a much better free throw shooter than that.
He's a good face-up shooter, so he should be able to make those free throws.
Down by 8. Elliott will get another free throw. 4 for 5 from the foul line today. Free throw up. That one good. 37-30. Hawks still down by 7, but beginning to make inroads to this big Coppin lead. Cephas backing down trim, lobs to the high post, right elbow. Blake Simpson back to the basket. Gives it up to Cephas, works a pick and roll. Simpson gets it right back to Cephas once again. They play a two-man game. Defenders switch. Cephas looking for a step back. He shoveled it to Smith and went right out of bounds on the near sideline. UMES basketball, another turnover for Coppin State. UMES basketball and left elbow Elliott face up. Hands it off to Trim. 5 minutes to go in the first. Elliott gets it again, going right at the foul line. Some contact, and he is bumped. This will be free throws for Elliott. Double bonus, it should be at least. First foul on the freshman, Blake Simpson. 2 free throws here for Elliott. Can make it a 5-point game if he knocks these down.
And he's shooting well from the free throw line.
Free throw from Elliott. Nails the first.
He's now 6 for 7 from the charity stripe.
4:59 to play in the first half. Second free throw from Elliott. Back rim, no good. Elliott gets his own board. Oh my gosh, they're going to call him for over the back. Elliott leaped over Tariq Cephas, who is 5'10", Dominic Elliott 6'8". Yeah, he kind of went over them, but there wasn't a whole lot of contact to get that rebound.
I was wondering if there was any contact going over there. That's what it looked like.
That is a bad, bad call. There's no doubt about that. Yes, he did jump over him, but he didn't need to touch him to grab the basketball.
No, he didn't.
He simply jumped, and from behind Cephas, he grabbed the basketball. Well, now they're going to place Cephas at the line, and this is another wrong call. It was Cephas who was fouled. That's the fact. And it'll send Simpson to the line, which I don't understand how you got Simpson there. The guy boxing out on Elliott was Cephas.
Simpson was on the low block, one side or the other.
I mean, this is a comedy here. It's 1-1 for Simpson. Hopefully we get that right. First free throw here from Simpson, 1-1. It's good.
He was on the low block on either side, one side or the other.
38-31, Coppin State by 7. Mike Myers will come back in. But geez.
Yeah, very quiet day for Myers so far.
Left-handed free throw here from Simpson. Makes them both. 39-31. Hawks quickly up ahead near sideline, right corner three, Walker. Got it. 39-34. Hawks down by five. Quickly back Coppin State. Shovel pass inside on the end line. Can't handle it. Simpson's out of bounds. UMES basketball once again.
You know, Walker's keeping the Hawks within shouting distance. A 4-for-4 from the three-point line.
4:42 remaining here in the first half. Trim, Blackman, Myers, Walker, and Elliott, the five on the floor for the Hawks. Trim walks it up casually. Bounces to the high post. Myers back to the basket, lays it back to Trim. Calls for a ball screen. Elliott sets it. Trim kicks to Walker. Right wing three deep from the beyond the arc. No good. Off the back rim, Cephas grabs the board on a bounce. Here comes Coppin State. Cephas pulls up. Kicks out. Josiah gets rid of it. Fripp into the lane. Shot no good. Blocking foul called on Mike Myers.
Yeah, Tripp has been very quiet for Coppin.
First foul on Myers. The good news for UMES, they do not have any foul trouble here. Two free throws here for Arnold Fripp, who's an 81% foul shooter. 4:11 to go in the half. Fripp's first free throw. Spins off left side. Hawks down by five. 39-34.
Yeah. Fripp had a tough first half. He's 0 for free throw and 0 for field goal.
Three dribbles for Fripp. Bends his knees, flicks the wrist. Front rim, no good. Elliott grabs the board. Hawks racing back the other way. Left corner, baseline drives. Walker hangs in the air. Got it to go off the glass. 39-36. Hawks down by just 3 points. Walker, 14 points. Getting inside that time. Cephas runs the point. Trim all over him. Crosses over, gets by Trim. Pulls up from 15. Left elbow, Jay. No. Walker grabs the board, falling to the floor. And they'll say he's out of bounds.
Timeout.
3:45 to go here in the first half. A timeout. Hawks have clawed their way back to a one-possession game, down three. It's Coppin State basketball. Myers, Elliott, Blackman, Trim, and Walker out there for UMES. Myers very quiet in the first half. Just 1 point for Mike Myers. Inbounding Cephas, nearly a five-second call, gets it in, passes, knocked away and stolen. Elliott grabs for UMES. Hawks can tie the game. Walker quickly up ahead. Passes to Blackman. Right corner three. Off the mark. Blackman grabs his own rebound. Ball knocked loose and out of bounds. Off of Smith. It will stay with the Hawks. Woo. That one brought the house down to tie the game.
Yeah, not kidding, man. It's a little more, the step is a little more lively for the Hawks over the last 2 minutes.
Hawks have never led in this game. They trail by three. 3:33 to go in the first. Trim lobs to the right elbow. Elliott face up. Bounce pass to Myers on the left block. Inside wraparound looking for Trim on a cut. Can't find him, and it's stolen by Coppin State. Too fancy there for Mike Myers. Smith. Passing to the top of the key, stolen by Blackman. A breakaway. Blackman goes up in the air, blocked by Smith, but a foul called, and Blackman will go to the foul line.
Blackman jumps into the passing lane. Quick feet. He's causing a problem out there for Coppin. Good running the floor. Free throws to come for Mark Blackman.
Just the first foul on Sterling Smith. He's been phenomenal. A 12 points on 5 and 6 shooting for Coppin State. Two free throws here for Blackman. The toss up. Yes. 2-point game now. 39-37. Shamari Triggs checks in for Coppin State. Blackman will see another free throw. 2 or 3 from the foul line today. Shot up. It's good. 39-38. Hawks down by just 1 point. Gary, front court left for Coppin State. Holds above his head. Now puts it on the deck. Left-handed bounce. Looking down low. Myers steals the entry pass. Here come the Hawks and Trim. Racing in the front court. Passes to Blackman. He'll fire along two, spins home. 40-39, the Hawks lead by one, their first advantage of the game. Cephas running the point, extra pass. Triggs, right wing three, back rim, hangs on the rim, no good. Myers grabs the board, and that's a foul on Coppin State. Brandon St. Louis going over the back of Myers. This will be free throws for the big man.
That's one of the few threes that did not fall, although it hung around the rim long.
About time that those three-pointers stopped falling through. Two. 2:39 to go in the first half. Hawks by one, 40-39. Myers has just 1 point today. Free throw up for the big man. Yep. 41-39, a 2-point lead now. Myers 0-for-3 from the field. He's gotten fouled plenty, though. This will be free throw number 6 of the game. Second one up, spins home off the glass, 42-39. Hawks up by 13, or rather 3, excuse me. It would be nice to be 13. 2:30 to go in the first half. Wrap around down low, St. Louis posting up. Slash and kick. Triggs sends it on to the corner. Smith working a pick and pop with St. Louis. They reset the Cephas. Rips it around the horn. Gary jabs left, goes right. Kicks to Triggs. Bounce pass down low. Stolen! Walker has it for UMES. Lob up ahead to Myers. Ahead of the rest, he's pushed from behind, and this will be free throws for Mike Myers. Brandon St. Louis will pick up his third foul. .239, the Hawks by 3.
Wearing them down. The lineup with Myers and Elliott, their combination together has proved successful for Coach Collins.
Free throw here from Myers, right rim off the mark. Blake Simpson will check in for St. Louis. We tend to go here in the first. Second free throw from Myers. Too short. He misses both. Gary rips down the board for Coppin State. Cephas racing up ahead. Slash and kick to the three. The corner, good. Shamari Triggs ties the game up 42-42. Under 2 minutes to go here in the first.
Without question, the three-point shot keeping Coppin in the basketball game.
Left wing. Trim looking for the lob, instead passes top of the key. Blackman hops in the lane. It's knocked off his leg and out of bounds. It's back to Coppin State.
Smart trying to do a little too much right now. The best thing to do is to throw the ball inside to Myers or Elliott, because they're working with some serious advantage down there now.
90 seconds to go here in the first half. Deadlock, 42 points apiece.
Coppin,
Gary near half court.
Coppin just trying to get to halftime, I think.
Gary trying to shake on Elliott down the right side of the lane, spinning around, baseline floater. Wow, off the glass and good.
The lefty from the right side, up and under.
44-42. Hawks down by a bucket, lob to the left block. Elliott spinning in the middle, kicks out Walker. He'll trigger right wing three. Yes, sir! 45-44, the Hawks by one, under a minute to go.
5 for 6 for Devin Walker.
Cephas backs his way into the front court. About 20 seconds, a differential shot clock and game clock. Gary left wing, trying to step back on Elliott, gives it up. Trim gets a hand in the passing lane, but kicks it out of bounds. Stays with Coppin State. Andino checks in for Blackman, who takes a seat. Walker in the face of Smith, lobs it into Gary. 12 to shoot for Coppin State, going one-on-one against Elliott. Yeah. And a hand check foul, hard contact, and now they're going to call Dominic Elliott for a technical foul. Yeah. 30.7 seconds to go here in the first. And these are going to be a couple of free throws for Gary. We'll see what the damage is here.
That's a free throw. It's also a personal foul on Dominic Elliott, which will be two fouls because he fouled him on the way to the basket.
Personal foul charge for the Hawks, number 32.
Elliott picks up his second foul. And they're also going to call Elliott for a technical, which will be his third.
Yeah.
So this should be four free throws. Should be four free throws for Coppin State.
Yes, it should be.
Third personal. Team's 10. The Eagles are now on the bonus.
And the foul was committed first.
Tariq Cephas will shoot two free throws. These are the technical free throws. First one up. It's good. Bobby Collins, pretty demonstrative, saying that Mike Myers was fouled the same way by Brandon St. Louis on the other end when he went hard to the floor. And there was no such extra dead ball technical called. Both free throws good from Cephas. And now Gary will shoot two foul shots.
Yeah.
With nobody on the line?
Because of technical.
Here's the free throw, gets it. So three of three on the trip. 47-45, Coppin State by a bucket.
It's a dead ball technical.
Here's another, and they make all four. And so now it's Coppin State basketball, presumably.
Oh yeah, it's a possible 8-point play, because if he makes a three-pointer and gets fouled on the shot, it's a
48-45, Coppin State by three. Smith inbounding right in front of our broadcast booth, lobs near the end line on the other way. Blackman right in the face of Cephas, bouncing up ahead. Shot clock is off with 25 seconds to go. Coppin State can hold for the final possession. They lead by three, 48-45. Gary, between the circles, left-handed bounce, going one-on-one against Tripp.
Who's going?
Shake and bake, going left. He stops the floater, front rim, no, bouncing around, slapped out of bounds off of Tripp. He'll stay with Coppin State, 3.6.
They've isolated Gary several times against different opponents. The left hand gets him open.
Smith will inbound. Nope. They'll switch him out for Cephas.
Tough inbound place, deep corner.
Blackman jumping in front of Cephas. Triggs pops open, right wing three, too short. And we're going to halftime with the score 48-45. Coppin State has a three-point lead. Things getting chippy at times. Two technicals called on UMES. Bobby Collins, none too thrilled about that. And
We'll play at the end of the half.
Bottom of the floor to start the second half for UMES. Johnson, Pitt, Myers, Walker, and Andino. Starting five for UMES tonight. Hawks move from right to left in the second half. Home white jerseys. Myers spinning around. Backdoor cut to Walker. Reverse layup with the left hand. It's good. Nice find by Myers. It leads down to 1 point, 48-47.
Great pass by Mark.
For Coppin State, they move from left to right in their road gold jerseys. Kessie, Cephas, Smith, down low, a bounce pass, looking for Betts, and it's stolen away by UMES. Racing the other way, Myers losing the ball, and he regathers, right-handed layup good on the breakaway. 49-48, the Hawks lead by one.
A little better start than the first half.
Flip out there as well for Coppin State. Far wing, Kessie, whips it. Left wing, here's Cephas. Hands it off to Kessie, behind the back dribble, looking for a step back. Instead, he skipped it to Smith. Inside runner, no, he gets rid of it. Bats the jumper off the mark from the baseline. Walker grabs the board for the Hawks.
Yeah, Coppin looked a little tentative shooting the basketball that trip down the floor.
And Dino to the foul line. Wrap around pass to Myers. He went for the dunk, but wave it off. There's a foul on the floor first. Christian Kessie picks up his third personal foul. 18:50 to go in the second half.
Yeah, Andino been quiet too for the Hawks, so I'm going to step out.
Andino has not scored today. He curls around a screen. He'll attempt the long two-pointer. Baseline Jay short, batted around and controlled by Fripp. Here comes Cephas, center of the floor, bouncing ahead to Smith. Open three-pointer. It's Kessie, nails it. 51-49. Coppin State back in front by two.
And that sounds familiar, that you said that numerous times this basketball game.
Minute and a half gone by in the first, or rather the second half. Top of the key, Myers. Hands it off to Pitt. Lob down low. Mike goes up in the air. He's undercut. It'll be a foul against Jeremiah Batts. Fouls on the floor, so the Hawks will go to an inbounds play underneath the hoop. That's the third foul on Batts. Pick, quick lob inside to Johnson. Foul line. Bounce pass Walker. Left wing three on its way. Rattles in and out. Flip the board. Coppin State controls. 2-point lead for the Eagles. Whipping it the other way. Kessie, jump stop in the lane. Kicks out, flip, three-pointer. Off the mark. Batted around. Myers saves it into Andino. Hawks to control. Now coming up the far sideline.
Good hustle by Mike.
Pitt in the lane, a jump pass. Myers at the foul line, behind the back, dribble to Andino. Left wing three, off the mark. Offensive rebound, Pitt. Oh, he's tied up. Possession arrow over to Coppin State.
Yeah. I don't think Coach Collins too happy with behind the back pass at the free throw line.
17:57 to go. Hurrying into the front court is Cephas. The Hawks a little slow to get back on D, but nothing comes of it. Cephas, center of the floor. Bounce pass near wing, long two-pointer. Kessie got it in the grill of Ryan Andino, and it's 53-49. So Christian Kessie responds to the Hawks' early run. He comes back with five of his own. Lob right elbow. Johnson face up. Goes to his right. Hangs in the air, left-handed shot. Fouled by Fripp. Free throws here for Yaman Johnson.
These guys that are left-handed are tough to guard. They put the ball right in your face. Every time they get a basket, you either get a bucket or you're going to get fouled if they're a good player.
Two fouls on Fripp. Here are two free throws for Iman Johnson, who has 2 points today, 2 of 2 for the foul line. First one up. It's good. 53-50. The Hawks still trail by three.
Yeah. On every free throw, too, just let the audience know that the Coppin only puts three guys on the line, and they put two guys all the way in the front court.
Second free throw from Johnson, short. Bounces off front iron. Rebound to Coppin State, unchallenged by UMES. Cephas hands it off to Kessie, left wing. Right back to Cephas. Trying to post up Batts, and now they'll call Myers for a foul down low, battling with Batts.
Myers really doesn't have to battle with him. He's physically and athletically quicker and stronger, so just play behind him. And when he turns around, he's got an easy block shot.
17:06 to go in the first half. Or rather, second half, excuse me. 53-50. Cephas lobs near half court. Jumping in the air, Smith to receive. Gives it up. Down low flip. Left block, turnaround, right-handed hook. Got it to drop. 55-50. Hawks down by 5. 3 minutes gone by in the second half. Ishak Pitta bounce it to Devin Walker, front court right.
I'm playing a packed in 2-3 zone.
Pitt backs up. Goes right, screen from Johnson. At the foul line, bounces it to Andino. Now he feeds the block. Myers, quick pass. Walker, corner three. Falling down, he misses. No call. Rebound to Coppin State, racing up ahead Cephas. Long two-pointer on the pull-up. It's off the mark. Myers grabs the ball, and a foul will be called underneath. And this goes against Christian Kessie. That's his fourth. Four team fouls on Coppin State already here in the second half. 16-27 to go in the game. UMES still down by 5, 55-50.
And Kessie sitting down is going to hurt Coppin. He came out of the gate the second half playing extremely well.
Ishak Pitt runs the point. Zone defense here from Coppin. Flashing towards the corner. Lob down low. Myers with the right hand. Can't finish. Goes back to the bucket. He misses. One more chance for Myers. Off the glass. No. Johnson on the follow. He misses. Tipped up in the air. Myers has it once more. The shot off the glass. No. Are you kidding me? A foul underneath. And this has to go against Coppin State. They missed 5 point blank shots. It's on Jeremiah Batts. That's his fourth. UMES basketball underneath the hoop again. Here's Brandon St. Louis.
5 shots.
Wow.
If one person had pump fake, they would have got a foul out of it quickly.
Ishak Pitt to enter. Looking to the corner. Walker pump fake. Baseline drive. Left-handed layup. He misses. Myers one more time. All right, here we go. Finally. On the 7th attempt. 55-52.
Offensive rebound stats. The padded.
Top of the key flip. Sends it on far wing. Smith reverses near side. 15:40 to go here in the second. UMES down by 3. Right corner. Baseline drive from Sterling Smith. He misses a layup. Iman Johnson rips down the board. Ishak Pitt jogging in the front court. Whips it into the corner. Walker quick entry. Myers to a cutting Pitt. Layup. Right-handed finger roll is good.
Yeah, that might be where Myers would be very effective today because he's had a couple assists to wide open cutters.
55-54. Hawks still down by 1. Feeding the block. St. Louis going to work on Myers. Right-handed hook off the glass. He misses. Pitt rips down the board. Here comes UMES. Bouncing up ahead to Walker. Inside penetration. A whistle and they'll call
jump ball.
A jump ball. Possession arrow gives it back to UMES. For Coppin State. Two players with 4 fouls, Batts and Kessie. Trim inbounding for the Hawks. Cutting towards the corner, Blackman receives on the bounce. Passes top of the key, Walker. Swings it on to Trim. Now Trim resets. 22 to shoot for the Hawks. Spinning into a screen from Pitt. Trim down the right side of the lane. Wild shot off the glass. No, batted out of bounds. It'll be off of UMES and go back to Coppin State. Hawks still down by one. They put on a full court press.
A little forced shot by Trim that time. Man-to-man, full court by the Hawks.
Now Blackman lays off, backpedaling as Cephas runs the point. Cephas far wing, passes to Triggs. Now reverses near side. Smith, stop and go, and his pass is stolen away by Trim. One-on-one on the fast break, hacked on his way up, and that'll be free throws for Travis Trim. Fripp thought he had a clean strip.
Yeah.
Instead, it'll be free throws for Trim and the third foul on Fripp. 16 fouls already for Coppin State, and we haven't even played 6 minutes.
And we're shooting on the next one for the rest of the half.
Hawks down by one. Travis Trim does not shoot a lot of free throws. 1 of 3 on the season. First toss up. Right rim kicks off. He can tie it up with this one. Trim another free throw. The toss up, good, and it's a tie ball game, 55-55. Deadlocked between UMES and Coppin State. Third tie of the game, we've had 6 lead changes. Dominic Elliott checks into the game for the first time in the second half with 3 personal fouls. Stevens up the near sideline, into the front court on Trim. 2 quick passes, far side, Triggs. Blackman falling down, Triggs gets in the lane, blocked by Ishak Pitt. Oh, what a swat. Pitt coming the other way for UMES. Prods into the lane, left-handed lip. Got to go! 57-55.
Yeah, under control that time. Pitt with a nice coast-to-coast drive with a left-hand finish.
Hawks by a bucket. Cephas coming the other way. Slash and kick Smith. Right wing 3. Back rim no. Devin Walker gets a hand to it. Saving it underneath the hook. Gets it to Pitt. Zips it up ahead. Blackman on a breakaway. One-on-one. Right-handed layup. Yes, sir! 59-55. The Hawks by 4. Cephas sprinting the other way, tripped up by Trim. Cephas falls to the floor. Trim thought it was all of his own volition.
Good call by the striped shirts that time. We'll give him credit for that.
First foul on Trim. Just the second team foul on UMES with 13:37 to go here in the second. Cephas back to the basket, backing down Mark Blackman on the right wing. Now takes a ball screen, hedging out Randall. Pick and pop with Gary, nowhere to go. He's holding the ball in the corner and calls for a timeout. They'll retain the possession. A good defense there from Shane Randall, hedging out on the defense and then recovering on Gary.
Yeah.
And of course, go ahead. 59-55. UMES leads by 4. 13-21 remaining in tonight's contest. Tariq Cephas to inbounds for Coppin State. On the end line, in the near corner. A lob into Triggs to start the offense for Coppin. UMES has come back after a three-point deficit. They trailed by as many as 13 in the first half. It was 3 points at the halftime break. A wild shot, no good. Rebound, UMES. Here comes Travis Trim the other way. Crossover into the lane. Kicks out Walker. Right wing three. Yes, sir! 62-55. It's a seven-point game. Devin Walker has 22. Cephas picks up his dribble. A bounce pass to Triggs. Gets it right back after breaking the press. Cephas going one-on-one against Blackman. Takes a ball screen. Moving screen! Fripp is called for his fourth personal foul. That's now three Eagles with four personal fouls. Dave, how's that going to affect the rest of this game?
Big time. The most effect is that Cressy has had to sit on the bench. I think that's the difference in the basketball game. He's already on there with four fouls. Another starter to be on there with four fouls. They're in trouble.
Hawks with a seven-point lead, 12:40 to go in the game. Eshak Pitt will run the point as he comes in for Travis Tripp. Beats the high post. Elliott, pump fake from the foul line. Backing down Fripp. Gets in the lane, and they call Arnold Fripp for a foul, and he has just fouled out of the game.
That's why they don't know it over there.
I cannot believe Coppin State left Arnold Fripp in the game, and he has fouled out with 12 and a half to go. That is unbelievable.
I don't know if there's a communication error there or just didn't know it.
Give UMES credit. They went right at Fripp. As soon as he got four fouls, Dominic Elliott knew it.
Yeah.
And they get a disqualification out of it. Blake Sentinel come into the game.
There's a lot of time left in this basketball game.
Fripp is their leading scorer on the season, and he can't play the rest of the way. Wow. That is unbelievable that that would happen in that circumstance. Dominic Elliott going to the line for two. Shot up and rattles in. We'll see another as it's 63-55. Hawks by eight. A big run here from UMES.
That's Elliott's 13th point, going for 14 now.
The shot up, front rim off the mark. Here coming the other way is Coppin State. Pump fake Triggs in the corner. Triggs, right wing. A pick and pop with Simpson, nothing going. Resets to Smith, far side. Smith works a screen and roll again, and a travel pivoting around. He drives the pivot foot. 63-55, your score. Dave, how about this? It was 55-50 at the 17-minute mark. It's been 5 minutes without a point for Coppin State. The Hawks have gone on a 13-0 run.
And it's a game of runs, and this is a good one for the Hawks.
Devin Walker off a handoff, a step back, long two, off the mark, back rim. Ball loose, it's ripped away by Myers. Hawks control. Bounce pass to Walker, pump fake, right wing. Steps back, he gives it up to Pitt. They reset the offense. 11:45 to play. Eshak Pitt, front court right. Little miscommunication with Blackman. Behind the back dribble. He gets in the lane. Backing down, he gives it up to Randall. Top of the key. Circles around to Myers. Left block, goes to the hoop. Oh, he traveled on the swift move. Turnover back to Coppin State. Yeah. And with 11:30 to go here in the second half, another timeout on the floor. UMES in the middle of a 13-0 run. They lead 63-55, an 8-point advantage. three wins in a row. Arnold Fripp has already fouled out of the game for Coppin State, their leading scorer on the season. Hawks are in the midst of a 13-0 run over the last 5.5 minutes.
Full court press by the Hawks.
Doug Newton here with Dave Bird. Mark Blackman all over Tariq Cephas in the front court right. Circles around. Passes to Gary Farside. A whistle and we got a foul. And it goes against Mark Blackman, bumping Cephas as he curled around a screen. Third foul on Blackman. Not much harm there. This is just the third team foul on the Hawks.
Hawks playing a lot better defense. They forced the Coppin offense way out toward midcourt.
After scoring 48 points in the first half, Coppin has scored just 7 points in the first 9 minutes of the second half, including no points in the last 6 minutes. Right wing Triggs, pump fake, gives it up to Cephas. Top of the key, crosses over to his left. Step back, loops around right side. Gary on Johnson. Going left, into the lane, lefty on lefty, crashing inside. We're going to get a foul on UMES.
I think Gary's the only player they got that can get to the rack. Mainly because he's left-handed, he keeps going left and uses his body extremely well to get in between the ball and the defender.
Second foul on Iman Johnson. These are two free throws for Dallas Gary, a 67% shooter, senior from Buffalo, New York. Free throw from Gary, good. First point in 6 minutes. For Coppin State, Gary went to Monroe Community College in Rochester, New York, the same community college that two other Coppin State Eagles went to. A pipeline there for Michael Grant and his Coppin State team. Gary makes both free throws. A lob in, Coppin State going to a full court pressure. Hawks with a 6-point lead, 63-57. Ishak Pitt splits a double team. High pass ahead, and it's into the hands of a player on the UMES bench. Out of bounds. Right back to Coppin.
Yeah, they tried to imitate Tom Brady on that baby and throw it about 40 yards downfield.
10:40 to play. Top of the key, Gary. Jabs left, goes right, into the lane, shot, fouled from behind. He misses the layup, but two more free throws for Dallas Gary. Where has this been all game for Coppin State? He's the only guy that seems to be able to go one-on-one into the lane. They got other players that can shoot the three, but Gary seems to be the off-the-bounce maestro. Free throw here from Gary, front rim, that one falls through.
He's got a nice touch too.
.10:34 remaining. Hawks leading by just 5 now as Gary scored 3 points in a row. The shot from the lefty, good. He's 4-4 from the line in this little stretch. 63-59, the Hawks by 4.
And full court press again by Coppin.
Ishak Pitt bounces into Myers. Quick double team, lobs overhead to Pitt. He pushes up the near sideline. Myers up ahead in the corner, resets to Pitt, and now Trim. Trim bounces to the high post. Pitt, a high-low pass down low. Lob to Myers, right-handed shot, misses, knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with UMES. Cephas last touched it. 10:16 to go.
They're allowing a little contact around the basket today.
Fresh shot clock for the Hawks. Trim inbounding, holds above his head. Kicks to the corner, open three for Andino. Yes, sir! 66-59.
Yeah, perfect step up time for Andino.
Hawks by 7. Smith, right wing. Loops around to Gary. Left wing, baseline penetration. Short on the layup, tapped up in the air. Myers controls for the Hawks. Simpson had a hand to it, but couldn't come down with it.
Well, we're letting him play on both ends.
Travis Trim slows it down. Heads over towards his bench and now backs up. Passes to Pitt. The wave begins to circulate here at the Hytche. The Hawks with a 7-point lead. Fans are feeling good. Trim. Front court right, right in front of his coach. Bounces to the high post pit. Looking inside to Myers. Sends it over to Trim. Now the entry. In the post, Myers has it knocked away. He's in the corner. Three to shoot. Gotta go. Baseline drive, fade away, off the glass. Oh, it falls through. The prayer answered. 68-59.
Maybe that'll get him going a little bit. The iron was extremely kind that time.
Mike Myers, 9 points today now. It's been slow for him, but finally beginning to awaken here. Top of the key three from Triggs. He's off the mark, batted around. Walker controls for the Hawks, and they are getting defensive stop after defensive stop.
Rebound after rebound. Got rebound in Coppin, 36 now to 23.
Lob down low to Myers is knocked away.
That's a big rebound differential, though. 36 to 23 on the glass.
Inbounds from underneath the hoop. Trim holds above his head. Looking for Andino instead, bounces it into Pitt. Well, Coppin State is the worst rebounding team in the league and has proven true today. And without Arnold Fripp, who is disqualified due to fouls, Hawks have an even bigger advantage the rest of the way. 8.5 to go, 10 to shoot. Trim's got to go. Crossover left to the foul line. Spins, kicks out Andino. Fade away, three. Oh, my! 71-59, the Hawks by 12.
Once you make one, you get kind of hot and feeling good.
Left wing three from Gary's off the mark. Offensive rebound. Smith saves it into Gary. Gary attacks the basket again. Cephas, wraparound pass, batted around. Loose underneath the hoop. Smith saves it. Attacks the basket with a left-handed layup. Blocking foul and the bucket. Chance for a three-point play for Sterling Smith.
Back-to-back threes have given the Hawks a little breathing room.
7:58 remaining here in the contest. The Hawks have a 10-point lead, 71-61. Flipped a 5-point deficit into an 8-point lead, and right now it sits at 10 points. So Sterling Smith does have a chance for a 3-point play here as he heads to the line. The foul was on Travis Trim, his second.
So the Hawks have taken a 3-point shot away from the Coppin, so that they have to penetrate and drive, and that you can't score as many points doing that. So the 3-point shot's not falling for him. It's going to be a tough 7 minutes and 58 seconds, I believe.
Smith heads to the foul line. Pauses between three dribbles. The free throw good. 71-62. The Hawks still lead by 9. Now they have to contend with full court pressure from Coppin State. Pitt gets it into Travis Trim. Jumps to receive. Bounce pass through a double team. Back to Pitt. Spinning away from the defense. Whipping it up the near sideline. Three-pointer Andino in the corner.
Yes, sir!
64-62, Hawks by a dozen again.
First half it was Walker, second half it's Andino.
Top of the key, here's Josiah, sends it on to Smith. Ryan Andino has hit three three-pointers. in the last five possessions. Gary, open from the top of the key. He'll trigger from three. He's off the mark. Knocked out of bounds by Josiah. It's Hawks basketball again.
Yeah, the Hawks have too many offensive weapons.
Eshad Kitt enters. Full court pressure again. Hawks navigating it pretty successfully here. Pitt on the bounce up the far sideline. Splits a double with the bounce. Resets to Walker and now Trim. 7:10 to go. UMES by 12. 74-62. Pitt circles back to Walker far wing. Left-handed bounce, whips at the Trim. 12 to shoot for UMES. Going right, ball screen from Pitt. Trim, far side, looking for Elliott. Popping out is Andino. Top of the key, three. Oh, my! Are you kidding me? 77-62, he cannot miss.
I'd say he's really hot now.
A 15-point lead for UMES. Andino has 12, all in the second half. Gary to the left block, his fadeaway no good. Bouncing around, pick controls for UMES, and a foul called.
Huh?
We didn't. They got a whistle and. What? They call it on Dominique Elliott when Eshad Kitt had the ball. Jeez.
That's his fourth.
6:25 to go. And this is two free throws, really one and one, I guess, for Dallas Gary.
He must have grabbed him on the way out.
Well, here's the thing. It was UMES had the ball, so it shouldn't be any free throws. It should be an offensive foul and should simply be possession. It wasn't a loose ball. It was UMES basketball here. They're going to correct it.
Yeah, we got it.
All right, now it's just an inbounds play for Coppin State.
Right. I guess he grabbed somebody who was chasing Pitt. I have to look at the video. We'll have to look at the video on that, sir.
Kessie to inbound for Coppin State. He has four personal fouls, so be wary of that for Coppin State.
But he's getting in. He's getting in when they're down now. Too late.
Inside penetration from Cephas gives it up. Simpson misses a layup. Walker blocked it, and now they're going to call a foul on Walker. Another foul on UMES, and a late whistle again. Well, it's only the first foul on Walker, but it's two free throws for Simpson.
Yeah. And the clock has stopped.
Right. 6:17 to go here in the game. First free throw from Simpson. Back rim, no good.
Two, bros, two.
Should be two. They're going for the rebound for no avail.
Hit in the game.
Simpson, who is just a 44% foul shooter, goes to the line for the second. Left-handed release. Off the left rim. Myers rips down the board, falling to the floor. He travels. He collided with Iman Johnson, both going for the rebound, and hands it right back to Coppin State.
Myers went from one side of the lane to the other side, but he didn't let his teammate get the ball.
Coppin State basketball, Cephas inbounding, whips it near side, Trim gets it and slams it off of the leg of Josiah. That's a steal, and nice heads up play by Trim to save the basketball.
Yeah, Coppin's in a little bit of a spiral now. The Hawks just need to play good defense, let the clock go, and we're out of here with a W. We're out of here with a W.
UMES basketball now dealing with full court pressure. Johnson and Trim. Passing back and forth, Trim passes up ahead to Myers. In the front court with 6 minutes to go, the Hawks slow it down. 77-62, UMES by 15. Trailed by as many as 13 in this game. And they have stormed back and have been in firm control here in the second half. Trim going right. Ball screen from Johnson. Five to shoot, Trim keeping himself. Spins in the lane, gives it up. Johnson, pump fake, gotta go. The 18-footer, air ball, and that's a shot clock violation. At least it's 35 seconds off the clock.
Yeah.
But with 5:35 left.
Nothing wrong with that. Pitt's going to come in here and control the offense. The clock will run.
After scoring 48 points in the first half, Coppin State has scored 7 points in the last 12 minutes. Here's a layup, rather a runner that's no good. Ball loose. Kessie misses a mid-range jumper. Rebound, Pitt comes down with it. Hawks basketball again.
Coppin's field goal percentage is going down and down. They can't make anything now.
Pitt backpedals towards half court. Going right, gets past Gary. No one picks him up. Right-handed layup is good. No help defense from Coppin State at 79-62. UMES by 17. Just blasting right by him was Ishak Pitt with a stop and go. Under 5 minutes to go. Kessie hands it off to Gary. Far wing. Passing high post. Josiah jabs left, goes right, spins back in the lane, hangs in the air, shot off the glass. No, Walker grabs the board. Walker up near sideline, hip check foul on Josiah, and this will be free throws for Devin Walker.
We got the foul shots, but the clock is still stopped. We do not need to be in any major rush.
19 fouls on Coppin State. This is 1-1 for Walker. He spins it off the left side, no good. Rebound Coppin State, coming back the other way. Gary into the lane, kicks it out of bounds. So it's off of UMES. Cephas to inbound for the Eagles. Hawks by 17, 79-62. Again, they trailed by as many as 13 in the first half. Cephas slides it inbounds. Three-pointer Kessie spins home finally. Kessie is back on the board. 79-65, Hawks by 14.
Yeah, full court press again. Kessie's back in. He's one of the better players, I think, and shooters.
Pitt loses the ball on the near sideline, gets it right back. Into the front court, and a timeout called by Bobby Collins to retain possession here.
Yeah, Coach Collins probably going to reiterate now that we're playing against the clock.
4:13 remaining. It is UMES 79, Coppin State 65.
Also, Coppin got in foul trouble. And one of the best shooters, Kessie, had to sit down. They lost their leading score with 12 minutes left to go in the game. So foul shots and foul trouble have hurt Coppin extremely.
And Dino to inbound for the Hawks. On the far sideline. Gets it into Pitt. UMES basketball, 23 to shoot. Pitt going right. Spinning on Kessie. Working with four fouls. Pitt kills the dribble, passes high post, Myers nearly loses it. Ball loose, Pitt gets it back, now lays it off to Johnson, two-handed jam! Elevation to make it 81-65.
Yeah, good touch pass by Pitt.
Right wing three is good for Smith, 81-68. Quick inbounds for the Hawks, they're down by 13. Is Coppin State, they put on the full court pressure and get a steal. Smith. Steps it out to Kessie. Extra pass Josiah. Corner three. Off the rim, no good. Myers controls. Here come the Hawks, and they're into the front court. And Dino to a cutting. Myers right in. It's on the Hawk. 83-68. Racing back the other way. Cephas in the lane. Floater. Got it to go. 83-70. 3:10 to play. UMES still by 13. Andino into the front court, lobs ahead to Myers. Instead of going one-on-one, and oh, he cuts inside to Johnson. Ran over a player, he misses an open layup, and a rebound to Coppin State. Cephas in the lane, lays it off to Josiah. This game getting very sloppy. Ishak Pitt's going to call a timeout underneath the hoop as he takes away a steal on the floor, and The Hawks will have possession with 2:49 to go.
A little sloppy now.
This game is deteriorating into an up and down dunk fest.
When Coppin goes to the bench, it's not quite the same player as the Hawks go to the bench.
Pitt, Trim, and Dino, Walker, and Elliott up there for the Hawks. 2:49 remaining in the contest. Pitt to inbound. Zips it into Trim. Lobs overhead, a double team. Back to Pitt. Still in the backcourt. Playing catch with Trim. Now up the near sideline. And Dino, corner three on its way. Spins out. Rebound, Coppin State pushing up ahead. Cephas nearly losing it. Regathers a jump pass. Here's a three-pointer. Left wing, Kessie. Back rim, no. Walker grabs for UMES. 2.5 to go. Andino, 2-on-1. Shovel pass to Trim. He spins it back out wisely. That's...
Well, where's Andino going?
Well, that's the difference between a freshman and a junior. Trim is really a senior. The walk-on will graduate this spring. Josiah... And we got a T now as he wraps up on Walker. Walker getting rid of the basketball. Either accidentally or intentionally hit Josiah with the ball. And then a shove in the back. Josiah is now going to pick up a foul. In addition to the personal foul as he wrapped up Walker. UMES by 13, 83-70. And whenever I said that game was deteriorating, here it goes again.
It's getting worse.
2:13 to play.
Yeah. Got to play under control, man. Got to play under control.
Both teams are huddled around their benches right now as the officials get it sorted out with the scorers table. Should be a media timeout, I do believe. 2:13 to play. They have not signaled that it's a media timeout.
No.
For the foul card for the Eagles, number 21, Jabari Joshua. That's his second personal, team's 10th. Then there's a double.
They're going to call a double technical foul on both Devin Walker and Josiah.
Number 21, Josiah.
And now it will be a timeout on the floor. All right, we got that sorted out. There'll be free throws for UMES when we return. It's UMES 83. Coppin State 70, a 13-point lead for the Hawks with 2:13 remaining. Final media timeout of regulation. Come back for the finish as the Hawks look to cap off their third straight win. You're listening to the Hawks Radio Network on SNR. 2:13 remaining in the contest. It's UMES 83, Coppin State 70. A double technical assist to both Devin Walker and Javari Josiah. Walker will shoot two free throws, however, after the personal foul. Free throw from Walker up, good. Devin Walker with a career high 23 points.
On 6-for-9 for three.
84-70. The Hawks by 14. Free throw good again. 85-70. UMES on a big run to close this game. It's a 30-15 run. Here's a pass inside.
Oh, don't.
Kessie going to the bucket. A layup and a foul.
I'm sure Coach Collins just probably said that in that break and huddle. We don't need to foul.
Dominic Elliott has fouled out of the game as we have a three-point play opportunity here for Kessie. Elliott will head to the bench with 2:04 to go. Both teams with one disqualification. It was Arnold Fripp with 12 minutes to go when he fouled out. Almost immediately after getting his fourth foul, Elliott was the one that attacked him and made him pick up that decisive fifth as Coppin State could not get him out of the lineup in time.
Yeah. Elliott finished with 13 points and 5 rebounds for the game. And a good game, I thought.
Free throw here from Kessie. Good, a three-point play indeed. 85-73. Dozen points the lead for UMES. Quick inbounds to Myers. Lob back to Pitt. Pushing up ahead to Andino in the front court. Andino spins through a double team. Gets it to Trim. Couple touch passes. They're going to call Triggs a foul, sending Pitt to the line. Minute 55 to go.
I still don't know where Andino is going down here in his left-hand corner, except to be double team. As good a shooter as he is, hold the basketball, somebody's going to hack him. And then he gets to go to the free throw line.
Ishak Pitt instead will head to the free throw line. Hawks with a 12-point lead, minute 55 to go. Free throw, no good. Too strong from Pitt. Hawks are looking for their third straight win. The two road wins at Bethune-Cookman and Florida A&M. Hawks are tied for the most road wins in the nation, but this a home game. Pitt makes one of two. It's now 86-73. UMES by 13. Top of the key, Garrett. Shakes left, goes right, gets past Myers. Reverse layup is good. 86-75.
15 points for the game for Jay.
Hawks by 11. Myers in the backcourt to a streaking Trim. Now Walker in the front court. Baseball pass up ahead. Andino, left wing. Minute and a half to go. UMES with an 11-point lead, and here will be free throws. For Ryan Andino, Cephas gives up the foul.
A smart play by the Hawks out front. You didn't want to throw the ball to Pitt. Much as I like Pitt as a point guard, free throw shooting is not his forte. So let's get it somebody who's a good free throw shooter, and we'll put this basketball game away.
Andino, a very good free throw shooter. He makes the first. 87-75. 12 points the lead for the Hawks. Minute 27 to go. Hawks looking to improve to 13-10. 6-2 in Nia Clay if they get it done. 88-75 after Andino nails both. Looks like it's going to happen for the Hawks. And then they'll head back on the road where they played so well.
Yeah, 15 points for Andino.
All of them coming in the second half. Gary coming back the other way, muscling up a layup. They wave it off, foul on the floor. It'll go against Iman Johnson. This is two free throws, double bonus for Gary, but no layup. No continuation for Gary. Gary with 15 points, 6-6 from the foul line.
A lot of points on the board for the Hawks today.
Free throw from Gary, back rim, no good. This is the most points that the Hawks have scored this season, surpassing the 87 they won. They scored against Savannah State in a win. 87-57 over the Tigers. Free throw from Gary. Front rim, he misses both. Myers the board, quickly wrapped up by Triggs. And now free throws for the Hawks. Well, it's looking, Dave Bird, like this will indeed be a victory. 13-point lead with a minute 20 to go.
As long as we make foul shots, it's a done deal.
And the Hawks will continue to sit in third place in the MEAC. And now they have to look forward to Howard on Monday, February the 2nd, going back on the road, where, as I mentioned, the most road wins of any team in the NCAA, tied with a couple teams, but still, they have been prolific and perfect in conference play, 3-0 on the road against MEAC teams.
Yep, downtown D.C., Howard University. We play them twice in about a couple weeks.
Myers' second free throw. He misses both. Rebound. Here comes Tariq Cephas. Racing up the floor. Hand off. Kessie, right wing three. He's off the mark. Smith, a tip back in the air, and it's good. 88-77. 11-point game. Minute 9 to go. Inbounds Pitt. Foul immediately by Triggs.
As soon as he touches the ball, Pitt's getting fouled. But the clock runs until a minute. After a minute, the clock's going to stop on a made basket. There's going to be a whole lot of time. He makes some foul shots.
Eshag Pitt going to the line. Just split a pair. Pitt today, 7 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists. He does it all for this team. Back rim, no good. Very good rebounder for his size, very strong, and gets the team into their right half-court sets. Leads the team with 3.8 assists per game. That keeps going up and up.
Yeah. Pitt's got 6 rebounds today. 6 rebounds, 5 assists.
Second free throw from Pitt. Again, he makes 1 of 2. So it's 89-77. Back to a 12-point game with a minute to go. Gary, top of the key, kicks to Smith. Right wing three, off balance, and he banks it in. 89-80. Same spot as Edward Stevens,
yeah,
against South Carolina State.
We've seen that same lineup before. Another bank. What's wrong with that board up there? We got to do
55.9 seconds to play. Time. Clamping down in the second half.
Yeah, foul trouble hurt Coppin a great deal.
Pitt inbounding. Gets it in to Myers. Quickly up ahead to Walker in the front court. Don't want to foul him. One of the better free throw shooters. He is wrapped up, however. You make these two. And again, that should maybe put the end to all the fouling and let this clock just run down to triple zeros, where the Hawks can celebrate their 13th victory of the year. 89-80 to score.
Yep.
Walker first free throw. Yep. 90-80. First time the Hawks have eclipsed 90 points this season.
He's just padding on his career high. 25.
25 points for Devin Walker. The native of Philadelphia. Big time shooter. He spins out the second free throw, 90-80. It's a 10-point game. Coming right back the other way, Cephas. He'll fire from 25. Front rim, no. Tipped up in the air. We got a foul underneath. Another stoppage of play. They're going to call this on UMES. Mark Blackman picks up his fourth foul. Well, clock stopped for Coppin State. 43.1 seconds to go. Kessie to the line. First free throw for Kessie. Double bonus. Got it. 90-81.
Number 0, Roll.
Myers and Andino check back in. Johnson and Blackman out. The offense defense subs for the Hawks. Van Roll, a sophomore from Edgewood, Maryland, into the game for the first time for Coppin. Guess he makes both free throws. It's 90-82. And at least guarantees probably another round of free throws here for UMES. Yeah. Coppin State's not going to let up yet. Trim into the front court on a long pass from Pitt. Not wrapped up quite yet. Pitt gets it. Monkey in the middle. Hawks playing keep away. They get it to Walker in the corner before finally wrapped up after, oh, 5 or 6 seconds gone off. 35.3 seconds to play. The Hawks leading by 8, 90-82. By the way, Delaware State, South Carolina State just getting underway down in Orangeburg. South Carolina State with an early 17-13 lead. Still 10 minutes left in the first half there. Walker free throw, got it. 91-82. Hawks by 9. Walker with a career-high 26. Back rim, he's off the mark. Rebound is batted around. Walker grabs it in the corner. Nearly dribbles it off the end line. He's saving it. And they call a foul on Coppin as he's falling out of bounds, trying to throw it back into a teammate. Coppin is pushing him, and that will be two more free throws for Devin Walker. Walker looks like he will finish his night 6 of 9 from the three-point line.
I know, very
and
good.
Considering the absence of Devin Martin, that was much needed for the Hawks.
Somebody had to come up and take his place, and Walker's done an outstanding job. Ryan and Dino, 14 points on the game, was also a big step up. He was a big key to second half.
All 14 points coming after halftime for Andino. 4 of 7 from beyond the arc. Walker makes 1 of 2. It's 92-82. Hawks by 10, 29 seconds to go. Smith, top of the key, going down the side of the lane. Left-handed layup. He misses. Walker grabs the board. Coppin State not fouling now with a 10-point lead and 19 seconds to go. Pitt will jog in the front court, and this should do it. 14 seconds. Trip with the basketball. 12 seconds. Now Coppin will choose to lay off, and the Hawks will win. 6 seconds remaining, 92-82, the final score. The Hawks improved to 13-10. They remain in third place in the MEAC, 6-2 in conference play. Celebrate that victory, folks. That's the post-game show coming up. You're listening to the Hawks Radio Network on SFMSports.net.